A very warm welcome wherever you are joining us from today. Later on in our service, we will be joined remotely by people from different parts of the world. But wherever you are now, you are most welcome to join with us as we celebrate Resurrection Day. You will find that all the words will be on the screen. My words in orange, and if you can respond with the words in blue. And you might wish to have some bread and wine to share alongside us later in the service. So we come together across the miles, across the internet, and we join as we celebrate and as we come to the cross.
There is a cross, and there is a crown. There is a hill where love's poured out, and lost are found. There is a man, so full of peace, and it's into his hands and on his feet. Come, come to the cross, come to the lies, come to the one who gave his life. Come, just as you are, out of the night, come to the one who gave his life. Just as you are.
So now we can join in that wonderful resurrection hymn, Jesus Christ is risen today. Easter Sunday, we celebrate particularly the fact that wherever we are, God is with us, that Jesus is alive and present with us now. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Loving Lord, open our hearts to your presence. Open our ears to your voice. Open our eyes to see your kingdom here in this place through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The risen Jesus appeared to his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
having made our peace with one another through wishing one another God's peace, we now come to make our peace with God. So let's reflect for a few moments and let's remember that it was our sin that nailed Jesus to the cross. We are the people who nailed Jesus to the cross. It was our sin he took upon himself. It was our death. He died that we might know forgiveness through him. So let us reflect on the sin that has caused his suffering. Our failings, even our deliberate actions for which we need to seek his forgiveness. And so we say together,
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. Thank you that in your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, you have forgiven all that is past. Grant that we may evermore remain in him and he in us, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Jesus gave his life for us on the cross so that we can be forgiven. And the good news is that to all who are truly sorry and believe and trust in him, Jesus says, your sins are forgiven. Go and sin no more.
Amen. Thanks be to God.
And so now we affirm our faith by reading these words taken from the book of Philippians, chapter 2. Let us declare our faith in Christ. He was in very nature God, but did not consider equality with God something to be used to his own advantage. Rather, he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness, and being found in appearance as a human being, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross. Therefore God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Our reading is brought to us today by Jim McNulty from the island of Islay in Scotland.
Our reading is from Colossians chapter 3, verses 1 to 4. So, if you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your mind on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, is revealed, then you also be revealed with him in glory.
This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. So let's listen and perhaps sing along with this hymn, In Christ Alone.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song, this cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still and striving cease. My comforter, my all and all, here in the love of Christ I stand. Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe. This gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on the cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. Every sin on him was laid. Here in the death of Christ I live. Bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands at victory, sin's curse has lost its grip on me. For I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. A part of Christ in me, from life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. And no power of hell, no scheme of man, can ever pluck me from his hand, till he returns or calls me home. Of Christ I stand, and no power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand, till he returns or calls me home. Here in the power of Christ I'll stand.
Our second reading is brought to us by Bruce, down in Trikivihati, on the island here. John chapter 20, verses 1 to 10.
The Gospel reading is taken from the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 20. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciple set out and went towards the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go inside. Then Simon Peter came following him and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple who reached the tomb said, and also went in, and he saw that and believed. For as yet they did not understand the scripture, that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes.
This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
It's not about him, it's about you. Easter is not about Jesus, it's about you. Otherwise, Easter is pointless. Yes, we give thanks for the cross and celebrate the resurrection. But if we don't see the relevance, then it becomes just what was described as the disciples' response to the report of the women about the empty tomb. In Luke's gospel, it says they thought it was just an idle tale. You see, the thing is, it stays as an idle tale if it doesn't actually impact us and transform our lives. Today, I could go through all the evidence for the empty tomb, for the resurrection of Jesus, and perhaps convince an unbeliever of the truth of the Easter accounts. But the mere facts of the historical event remain as history, without the radical transformation of our lives. You see, if Easter doesn't change us, then we've missed the point. The events we celebrated this past week and in the lead up to it are full of drama and despair. From the heights of the acknowledgement of Jesus as King to the tears and the desolation of the crucifixion. And then the mystery and excitement of the resurrection. In the mid-60s, there was a film about the life of Jesus entitled The Greatest Story Ever Told. But again, unless it's actually impacted you, it remains just a story. Easter is for you. Easter is about you. And Easter is God's greatest gift for you in Jesus. Yes, we talk about Christmas and give gifts to celebrate the gift of Jesus to the world. And without Christmas, Easter wouldn't have happened. But it's Easter which is God's greatest gift to you. Jesus rode into Jerusalem as your king. But he's only your king if you actually acknowledge him as king. Jesus brought in a new kingdom, the kingdom of God. But it's only your kingdom if you're a citizen of it. Jesus died on the cross, his body broken and his blood shed, sacrificing himself for the forgiveness of your sins. But your sins are only forgiven if you receive that forgiveness. Jesus rose from the dead so that we too might be raised from the dead. But we're only raised from the dead when we have died to our old lives and we've received that gift of forgiveness. A new life in him. It's all about you and your place in his world. He came to the world out of love for you. He inaugurated the kingdom of God as a home for you. And he died on the cross so that you might be forgiven. He rose from the dead so that you might rise to new life too. He is the source. He is the driving force. He's the solution. He's the refuge. He is the resurrection and the life. And it's all for you. And it's all for us as we respond together. The letter to the church in Colossae puts it this way. You have died and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When we are baptized by faith, we actually die to our old lives. We are dead to the world. Going down in the water of baptism symbolises that dying, and coming up from the water symbolises rising from the dead into our new lives. On the cross, our slavery to sin was crucified. Sin for us is dead. and we're free. Free to live our new lives. And more than that, as our old lives died with Christ, so we are raised to life with Christ. And just as he now lives forever, so do we. That's the gospel. That is the good news. All that Jesus did and all that he does for us. We're free from the bonds that tie us down, that hold us back in life. We're free from the things of the world that perhaps we think we've got control over, but are in fact controlling us. And that focus is on us. Our reading from Colossians speaks of seeking the things that are above. We're let into the heart and the desires of God for his world. We're not held back by worldly fears. We can see over and above all the mundane things of life to something that's far better. And it's not that we aren't involved in the world. It's that we're in it to transform it. As Jesus lives in us, as Jesus lives through us. For him, it's all about us. We've been the focus of his love from the very beginning. His love for us, his death for us, his resurrection for us, and his transformation of our lives. Our focus changes to focus on him. We live with him, and we live our lives with God and for God. Easter isn't an idle tale, but a living reality. We get to live as Christ, with access to that resurrection power that can bring new resurrection life to others. Christ in us and through us can raise others from the deadness of life because of the resurrection. Christ in us and through us can actually demonstrate new life to those around us. Christ in us and through us in all that we do and say can bring resurrection life to a dead and dying world. Every generous act we do for others shows the risen Christ. When we touch the untouchables, when we reach into the gutters of society and make a difference, we show the risen Christ. When we take food parcels to the poor, we show the risen Christ. When we stay at home and don't break the lockdown regulations, we show the risen Christ. When we speak loving words, we overcome that drive to cause division and hate that there is in the world, and we show the risen Christ. We live resurrection lives. As those who are born to new life and are raised from the dead old lives of the world to a new life lived with him. Enjoy your resurrection. Share your resurrection. And show your resurrection life. Because his resurrection was all about your resurrection. Let's pray. Father God, we are raised to new life in Jesus. You have done incredible things for every one of us. Help us to show your resurrection life to all those we meet, every day and in every way. Amen.
Our prayers are brought to us today by our trainee lay reader, Ruth, from Tutbury in Staffordshire.
In our prayers today, after each section, I will say, "Your kingdom come," and the response is, "Your will be done." Let us pray. As we come to pray, we remind ourselves that on this day, of all days, when we particularly remember and rejoice at Christ's resurrection, that we serve an almighty God who is Lord of all, of life and death. We serve a risen Lord who knows what it is to suffer and grieve and has paid the ultimate price to bring us into relationship with him. And we are loved by the one who is both the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world, and the Lion of Judah, who was and is victorious against everything that is set against his rule and his reign. Christ is risen, and the power of his resurrection fills the world today with new life, hope, and expectation. And so we bring him all our needs. Almighty God, we think of your church today celebrating the resurrection over all the world. This year is so different for many of us celebrating in our homes and all of us unable to meet in our church buildings. Nevertheless, we meet, whether that is virtually over the internet or via phone conversations or messages to each other. May our worship and our joy on the day of resurrection make us one in the gospel. We pray that the Holy Spirit may guide and strengthen us in mission and service, praying that day by day we may grow in love for you and for our brothers and sisters in Christ. We pray that these times of isolation will help us to be more considerate of those, whether through ill health, imprisonment, or any other cause, are forced to endure days and nights alone. Your kingdom come.
Your will be done.
Jesus Christ, our risen Lord, you travel through towns and villages curing every disease and illness. At your command, the sick were made well. Come to our aid now during the global spread of the coronavirus, that we may experience your healing love. Heal those who are sick with the virus. May they regain their strength and health through quality medical care and your gracious hand at work. Heal us from our fear, which prevents nations from working together and neighbours from helping one another. Protect those who through extreme poverty across our world must live in close contact with each other and cannot self-isolate. Heal us from our pride, which can make us claim invulnerability to a disease that knows no borders. Help us all to be considerate and not to take risks which make us and those in our communities vulnerable. Your kingdom come,
your will be done.
Loving Lord, healer of all, stay by our side in this time of uncertainty and sorrow. Be with those who have died from the virus. May they be at rest with you in your eternal peace. Be with the families of all those who are sick or have died. As they worry and grieve, defend them from illness and despair. May they know your peace. In a moment of silence, we name those on our hearts before you now. Be with the doctors, nurses, researchers, and all medical professionals who seek to help and heal those affected and who put themselves at risk in the process. We pray for them and their families. May they know your protection, your strength, and your peace. Your kingdom come,
your will be done.
Be with the leaders of all nations and their governments. Give them the foresight to act with charity and true concern for the well-being of the people they are meant to serve. Give them the wisdom to know how best to manage the current situation and when to put in place or remove restrictions to prevent the spread of the virus. Give them wisdom to invest in the appropriate long-term solutions that will help prepare for and prevent future outbreaks. May they know your peace as they work together to achieve it on earth. Your kingdom come.
Your will be done.
Whether we are at home or abroad, surrounded by many people suffering from this illness or only a few, Jesus Christ, stay with us as we endure and mourn, persist and prepare. In place of our anxiety, give us your peace. As we live in this very different world at this time, we pray that we may reflect your love in our families, our church, and our community, so that the world can witness that we are followers of the risen Christ and draw others into his loving care. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. And now we bring together all our prayers in the prayer that Jesus taught us, either using the words on the screen or in the language or the version you know best.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Amen.
As part of the offering of yourself to God, you may wish to send a donation for the work of the chaplaincy across Fuerteventura. Some of what we receive is given to support the Spanish Association Against Cancer, our local branch here on Fuerteventura, and some is sent to Tear Fund for international relief and development work. Bank details are on the website. A glorious Easter song, remembering that this is our resurrection too.
I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my turn till I made. I was breathing but not alive. All my failures I tried to hide. It was my turn, yeah, till I made. You called my name and I
out of the darkness, into story. This is your story. Come on, listen.
I needed rescue, my sin was heavy, but chains break at the weight of your glory. I needed shelter, I was an orphan, now you call me a citizen of heaven. Well, I was broke.
Eucharistic prayer. The Lord is here.
His spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Lord of all life, you created the universe where all things reflect your glory. You give us this great and beautiful earth to discover and to cherish. And you made us all, each wonderfully different, to join with the angels and sing your praises.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
We thank you, loving Father, because when we turned away, you sent Jesus, your Son. He gave his life for us on the cross and shows us the way to live. Send your Holy Spirit that these gifts of bread and wine may be for us Christ's body and blood. On the night before he died, when darkness had fallen, Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, broke it, and shared it with his disciples, saying, "This is my body, given for you. Do this to remember me." After they had eaten, he took the cup of wine, gave thanks, and shared it with the disciples, saying, "This is my blood, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins." So, Father, with this bread and this cup, we celebrate his love, his death, his risen life. As you feed us with these gifts, send your Holy Spirit and change us more and more to be like Jesus, our Saviour. And we look forward to the day when Jesus will come again, when all suffering will end and all creation will be gathered in the Father's loving arms. And now, Father, with all your saints, we give you glory through Jesus Christ in the strength of the Spirit, today and forever.
Amen. Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in the one bread.
Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Eat this and remember Jesus.
Amen.
Drink this and remember Jesus.
Amen.
We give thanks together as we say, Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory.
Amen.
The best place to look for information at the moment about what's going on is on our website. So make sure you keep going back to have another look It does tend to get updated a couple of times a week at the moment. We were collecting during Lent food and toiletries for distribution to those who are living in poverty on the island. We're actually going to continue that for the moment. We won't be collecting anything on this next week, but you can be collecting things ready for being picked up the following week. And I will be doing the usual, going around, picking up the parcels from those who gather things together, and then usually delivering them down into Puerto del Rosario on a Wednesday. So contact me if you need anything picking up to be taken down there. Our main notice sheet is on the website, and you'll find at the moment that won't be changing much, because all our services and meetings in the chaplaincy are cancelled until further notice, but we will be doing our online worship weekly. Again, go to the main page on the website, the latest service will be up on that, and you'll be able to link straight through to it from there. So let's gather together in our hearts and minds as we sing the praises of God, the risen Christ. Thine be the glory. Strengthen you to walk with him in his risen life. And the blessing of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you now and always.
Amen.
Go in the peace of the risen Christ to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.